we survive? And that's the subject of the 2009 model year discussion for Nissan. The first and foremost, great products. First-in-class innovations like spray and bed liner. We have that on Frontier, we have that on Titan. We were first to market with innovations like that. Those are critical innovations that drive consumer shopping behavior. So those are things that we recognize are very important. DQR, very important to continue to improve. We know that that's a key purchase driver for products in this segment, more so in these segments than in, say, sedans, etc. So having the great products out there with the right features is very important. Similarly, having production flexibility. Obviously, sales volumes across the industry are going down, and we have the right kind of flexibility in our manufacturing facilities here in the U.S. to be able to taper down the production and focus on some of the other vehicles that may be selling well. Obviously, adjusting product mix is going to be very important. So having the right model mix in a time like this becomes even more important. So for example, on Frontier, we recognize that the four-cylinder sub-segment in the compact pickup truck segment is going up. So we need to make sure that we have the right availability of four-cylinder Frontiers. That's one of the actions that we're taking to try to adjust to the time. Similarly, adding value. We recognize that the consumers that are out there right now are very rational consumers. They're not making decisions that are purely emotional. So they're looking for a value proposition. So as we go through some of the detailed discussions on the vehicles, I'm going to give you some examples of things that we're doing as an OEM to enhance the value proposition for our customers. Probably first and foremost, and one of the most important things is to not panic. And that's one thing that we, as an organization, have taken very seriously. We don't want to walk away from these segments. Again, as I said before, we do feel that they're going to come back in the future. So that means putting reasonable C&I on the table without killing value. Those are very important tactics for us. And then finally, supporting our dealers. Our dealers are still very much engaged in these products. So the responsibility falls on our shoulders to really support them with what they need in order to drive demand. So things like very focused marketing campaigns. So we go into the regions where we know we're going to have high return on investment for ourselves as well as for our dealers. Making sure that we have the right product at the right place at the right time. And what I'm referring to here is the complexity of our vehicles, the build complexity. So the number of buildable combinations of our vehicles. We take this very seriously because we know that by having a lower number of buildable combinations, we'll optimize our chances of having the right product in the right place at the right time. So we work very closely with our dealers, with our field staff, to understand what specific buildable combinations are moving, and we adjust our product lineup accordingly so that we can optimize the chances of selling the vehicle. So those are kind of the strategies that we're taking as a manufacturer and as an approach to weathering the storm that we're seeing right now in the truck and SUV market.